and spreading the word to the people who needed to hear. Oh, I readily did accept Muhammad's message from God. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, the Prophet's faithful friend, trusted and protected him. His love had no end. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, Allah be pleased with him, companion in Jannah, oh blessed by Allah, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq.
Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu, wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyi'ati a'malina. Man yahdihi Allahu fala mudilla lah, wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah, wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And welcome to Righteous Companions. Brothers and sisters in Islam, if you recall at the very beginning of the series, I have mentioned so many reasons why we decided to present to the Ummah the series Righteous Companions. And one of the reasons that I shared with you at the beginning of the series, in the first four episodes, that that generation did something called transformation. They transformed from nothing to something. And I really mean that. They were nobody, they were nobody, period. To the extent that when the Prophet ﷺ sent to the ruler of Persia a letter inviting him to Islam, he was shocked. These Bedouins are telling me where to kneel to? Brothers and sisters in Islam, today I want to share with you a story of a companion who was nobody, but he is somebody after Islam. Here we are, 1400 plus years later, after his death, talking about him. This episode, and maybe the next episode, as I talk about this companion, it's an invitation to the youth of the Ummah, or to the people who feel that they are useless. And sometimes we feel that. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not create you and me just to eat and drink and enjoy this world. Rather, to do something, to leave something behind you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chosen you to be a Muslim, transform, an invitation to you to transform, to change. Give yourselves a chance and you will see that you can make it happen. Brothers and sisters in Islam, without any further delay, the companion that I would like to talk to you about today, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said about him, his feet will be heavier in the scale than the mountain of Uhud. Again, Uhud is a terrain, huge terrain of rocks. The feet of this companion in the scale, in the day of resurrection, will be heavier than the mountain of Uhud. You know why did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said this, and the occasion in which, during which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam made that statement? Why? Because Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, and that is his name, Abu Abdurrahman, رضي الله عنه. That is his kunya. He was known to be a very small in size, a very little man. If you read his biography, you will learn that when there is a strong wind, he hardly would hold himself to the ground. The wind would move him because of his little size. He doesn't have a lot of flesh, small man. You also learn that, subhanallah, this man will be heavier in the scale than the mountain of Uhud. When did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam made that statement? One day, he was sitting with his companions, and Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, radiyallahu an, went climbing a tree called the Arak, the tree where you get the siwak from, the siwak that we use. And it's highly recommended upon every Muslim before the salah and after wudu to use the siwak. So as he's climbing the tree, the shin of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was exposed. The two shins of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud were exposed to the companions. And they are so small. So the companions looked at one another, amazed at how small Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is. You know what did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says? أَتَعْجَبُونَ مِنْ دِقَّةِ قَدَمْ ابْنُ مُعَبْدْ. Are you amazed at how thin the shins of the son of Ibn Abd, and that is Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ, by the one in whose hand my soul is, they are heavier in the scale than the mountain of Uhud. Ya Allah! Brothers and sisters in Islam, how did Abdullah ibn Mas'ud attain that status? We believe as Muslims that in the day of resurrection, the limb that will give you weight is the heart. And the heart is the container of iman, of faith, the container of the deen. Brothers and sisters in Islam, that is why Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu would outweigh the mountain of Uhud if in the scale in the day of resurrection. We also know from hadith in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam that a heavy man will come in the day of resurrection and he will be placed in the scale, and he will not weigh a wing of a mosquito, because the heart has no iman, has no faith. Brothers and sisters in Islam, do you know the first meeting between the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu out of this world? And the author fi musnad al-imam Ahmad rahimahullah, and here the narrator himself, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, he said, كنت أرعى غنما لسيد من سادات قريش. I used to work as a shepherd to one of the leaders of Quraysh, a kafir, someone whose name is عقبة ابن أبي معيط. He never became a Muslim, this man. He died as a kafir, actually. So, I was shepherding, and one day, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu an Abi Bakr wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad, they were in the desert and they approached me. They were trying to take a break from the persecution and the harm of the disbelievers. So they decided to go to the desert. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked me, "Can you give us milk?" I told them, "No. I am working for someone else. These are not my sheep. وَإِنِّي مُؤْتَمَنْ And I'm entrusted." Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, "Do you have a sheep that was not touched by a male, never delivered before, impossible for it to have milk?" He said, "Yes, you can take this one." The Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam wiped over the area where you get the milk from the sheep, and he made dua, and by all the sudden, milk was there. He milked the sheep, and then after that, he commanded the area where the milking is, "Iqlis, go back to your former state." And then he handed over the sheep back to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud after he got the milk that he needs for himself and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, upon seeing this miracle, he approached the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "O Messenger of Allah, teach me of what you just did." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, "Innaka ghulamun mu'allam." You are a learned person already, a learned young man already. Let's take a short break and come back. Talk a little bit more about this companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who used to be a shepherd and he used to be nobody. And let's find out how he transformed to be one of the elite of the companions, so that you may follow his footsteps and do the same, because the ummah needs you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
How readily did he accept Muhammad's message from God?
The aim of the show is to really focus and gain a grasp of those things which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, and those things which will gain for us the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and will make us amongst those who are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Is there any evidence from the Quran that shows that those who repent are beloved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more happier with the repentance of his slave than you if you came across your camel after you lost it in a wide open.
The love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enable us to reach into a status wherewith or in which we will taste the beauty of Iman.
We would like to be amongst those who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves.
Indeed, you will see your Lord as you see this moon without having any harm in seeing them. Way how we fast. We might fast, we might abstain from the drink. At the same time, we violate Allah's boundaries. And then how can we get taqwa?
The entire staff at Hoda would like to wish you a wonderful and blessed Ramadan.
How readily did he accept Muhammad's message from God? Muhammad's message from God.
Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back to Righteous Companions. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, upon meeting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and seeing his miracle, he immediately looked for him and he proceeded to the location where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to teach the companions about the religion and recite the Quran to them, the well-known location in the seerah, Dar al-Arqam ibn Abi al-Arqam, the house of al-Arqam ibn Abi al-Arqam. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, the shepherd, the nobody, decided to become somebody
and he took the first step by identifying himself to be a Muslim. And he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. From that time on, brothers and sisters in Islam, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu did not spare any second, but he accompanied the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, seeking to learn from him. He still remembers these words that he recited when he got the milk out of a sheep that never been touched by a male. He wanted to learn. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when Abi Musa al-Ash'ari radiyallahu anhu and al-Ash'a'ira and his family, they came from Yemen to learn about the deen. When they arrived, they always saw Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu around the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, to the extent that they thought that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is from the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam actually given him a very special privilege. He told him, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, you are one of the family now that you do not have to ask permission. No more permission. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, brothers and sisters in Islam, when one of the predecessors, his name is Abdul Rahman ibn Yazid, asked Hudayfa ibn al-Yaman radiyallahu anhu about the person who is the closest in appearance, manners, talking, walking, أقربوا الصحابة سمتا وهديا لرسول الله حذيفة بن اليمان رضي الله عنه said عبد الله بن مسعود. Brothers and sisters in Islam, عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه embarked on learning the religion, and this is the second step that you need to make, that you need to take in order to transform. Learn, brothers and sisters, about this beautiful religion. Learn who is your Lord, what is your deen, and what do you know about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Three questions that you will be asked as soon as they take you out of this world. Dig a hole in the ground and bury you and leave you alone. Two angels will come to ask you those three questions. If you want to transform, if you want to be someone like Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anh, learn the answers to these three questions and implement them. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anh, he actually made a statement exactly that means what I just said. ليس العلم عن كثرة الحفظ. Knowledge is not that you memorize a lot of text. Knowledge is practice that you implement. Knowledge is the implementation and the fear of Allah. إنما العلم الخشية. The fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu learned from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam the Quran. He said, لقد أخذت 70 سورة من في الرسول sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I have taken 70 verses, 70 surahs, 70 chapters of the Quran from the mouth of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. لا ينازعني فيهم أحد. No one can compete with me regarding them. Wallahi, by Allah, I know what every verse of the Quran was revealed for and when and where. And if I know that there is someone else who has more knowledge than me, I will travel to him. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud brothers and sisters in Islam, impart on learning. The knowledge of the deen will feed your heart. One of the statements that he made, that the disbelievers are very healthy once it comes to their body, but they are very sick once it comes to their heart. But a believer is healthy once it comes to his heart, and he could be sick once it comes to his body. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala careless about you if you have a healthy body and a sick heart. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be mindful of you if you have a healthy heart and a sick body. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the ummah, actually, take the Quran from four. خذ القرآن من أربع من أراد أن يسمع القرآن غضا طريا. If you want to hear the Quran the way it was revealed to me, hear it from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Recite it the way that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud recited. Take the Quran from four. Guess who's the first in the list? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. سالم مولى أبي حذيفة أبي بن كعب معاذ بن جبل ابن مسعود ابن أم كعب. The small man, the shepherd, was the first in the list. Brothers and sisters in Islam, his experience and beautiful recitation of the Quran and knowledge of the Quran was so known, to the extent that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam asked him one day to recite the Quran to him. Ya ibn Mas'ud, iqra' alayya al-Quran, recite the Quran to me. Faqala ya Rasul Allah, O Messenger of Allah, a'aqra'ahu alayka wa alayka unzil? How can I recite it to you when it was revealed on you? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنِّي أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَسْمَعَهُ مِنْ غَيْرِي. I like to hear it recited to me by others. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu started reciting Surah An-Nisa. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَّفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً. الآية all the way until he reached this verse. فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَى هَؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam started weeping and crying. And then he said to Abdullah, Ya Abdullah, hasbuk, stop, that is enough. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the knowledge is what given Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu that status in the ummah. If you want to transform from where you are to someone else, begin from there. Brothers and sisters in Islam, again, remember the objective of learning about righteous companions is to present to you people who did the transformation so that you can follow their footsteps. Here is a shepherd, did it. He became one of the best in the ummah once it came to the knowledge of the deen and once it came to the Quran, to the extent that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Quran regarding Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, when the disbelievers asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to make a special gathering for them, the leaders of Mecca, Abu Sufyan, Abu Jahl, and others, they said, we would like to hear your message, but We don't want to sit with Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Khabbab and Suhaib. They stink. We want a special gathering for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَا تَطْرُدِ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ. Do not dismiss Ibn Mas'ud, Suhaib, and Khabbab, and Bilal for these people. If they want to be with them, let them be with them. But stick to these poor ones because they are the true believers. Brothers and sisters in Islam, my time is up. Insha'Allah, the next episode of Righteous Companions, I would like to share with you and with the Ummah how much Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anh, as he was knowledgeable of the Quran, he was also knowledgeable of the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, so that you can follow his footsteps and learn the Quran and the Sunnah so you can transform like he did transform. Till the next episode, Righteous Companions. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Companions spreading the word to the people who needed to hear. Oh, how readily did he accept Muhammad's message from God. Abu Bakr Siddiq, the Prophet's faithful friend, trusted and protected him. His love had no end. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Allah be pleased with him. Companion in Jannah, oh blessed by Allah. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, the Prophet's faithful friend.